Planet St. Croix. So for this video, this is all about smallmouth bass. And I will say there's multiple ways to catch these fish. I only fish the hot tubs for these as well. So as soon as I can find my smallmouth bass here, it's right around a 10 pounder. In fact, he's bigger than my unique largemouth, which I'm hoping to fix here one of these days. So here it is. .332 caught here in St. Croix. So how did I do it? Well, this is how I did it. So once again, I'm using a DLC fishing setup. I believe this is out of the Dragon. And a bass jig 1 1/2 ounce 4-0 hook, brown color, pumpkin melon. And we're gonna go here to the Vanishing Rock Light. And we're just gonna fish around these two pylons. But I am going to fast forward the time to about 3 p.m. So here we are, and we're just gonna, like I said, just cast around and lift and drop is what I was using. Yeah, it does take a little bit to get down. But just a little lift and drop. If this set up, I could really cast out like over 200 and some feet. So this is a rod I like to use quite a bit. Oop, I was on something there. Didn't get him hooked. Just to show you how far I can cast. Excuse me. Almost 230 feet. Now I'm hoping they do add something to this part of the water, because I like to go out there and fish one time. Get on a boat, and there you go. Look at that fish way out there. Doesn't seem too big here. I'm going to crank it up a little. Ooh, man. Yeah. Ooh, pardon me. Got to sneeze this morning. Alright, so just 3 pounder, that's your average size for here. I do apologize. Seems like I am coming down with a cold here today. Ah, best one right there. And I have caught some here close to shore, so don't always give up once you get close. But also beware, there are snags in this area as well. Okay, it's not like Alaska where salmon come up and hit it right as you're pulling it out of the water. It's not like that, so once you get that close, you can go ahead and pick it up. I actually found this spot during a tournament back during the summer, using probably different jigs here. Like I said, I only fish for these guys during the hot times. I don't fish for them when it's down, when the times are down and low. Missed another one right there. And casting over here near this left pylon, our buoy, there are some snags as well. Get tons of bites here. Don't hook up as much as I would like to. And of course, if you have any X series, use those. You catch more fish on the X series than you will the basic ones. There we go. Fish on. Oh, he wouldn't jump out and say hi. And as you see, most of them are 3 pound, right in the 3 pound range. There's another one. So the bite must be starting to pick up a little bit more. A little bit smaller. There's another one. This one's biting a little bit more, so this might be a trophy. We'll see. Nope, this is another 3 pounder. There you go, fish on. This one was out there. He was way out there. And we're probably just going to go ahead and end with this one. So, getting a little smaller on me. See if we can catch one more bigger one. Go for a bigger one. Where's the next lucky fish? Next lucky fish. See, there we go. We got one right close next to the shore right there. But he was a small one. But this is how you catch them. You can catch trophies. You can catch uniques. It just so happens it's not happening while I'm recording. But thank you for watching, and hopefully this helps you out.